Hey makers, it's Charlotte and I'm here with Matt, our in-house skin and hair care expert. Today, Matt and I are going to talk to you about testing and stability requirements when it comes to selling your skincare products. Matt, give us an overview of what our customers need to do when it comes to this topic.
Great, thanks Charlotte. So when it comes to qualifying a new formula for product safety and stability, stability is just a fancy word for shelf life, in case you were wondering. It's best to follow the GMP guidelines for this testing, which are clearly laid out on the website, but the general overview is that you provide a stability study that is done in an incubator at accelerated temperatures for 2 to 3 months, and depending on the duration of this study, you will have a validated 1 or 2 year shelf life claim. The other component of this testing is regarding consumer safety, and what's done is a form of clinical testing called a RIP test, which is HRIPT, or Human Repeat Insult Patch Test. And what this does is they make sure that this product's not gonna affect consumers who would wear it on a day-to-day basis.
Super helpful. So for you guys, that is basically covering the R&D phase of your product. So when you're developing a new product, those are the steps that you wanna take. Now, let's say our makers are ready to go into production and they're ready to sell their product. Is there anything that they need to do for their production batches?
Yes, all production batches should have a valid third-party microbial contamination test to validate that their product does not have an excess amount of bacteria or mold in it before it was sold.
If you guys are wondering where to find resources to get this testing done or how much it's going to cost you, Matt and I suggest looking locally. There are third-party labs that perform these services in major cities and small cities even all over the United States. So head to what I call Google University and search for a local lab near you. This is typically pretty budget friendly as well, but you can get pricing from the specific lab that you choose to work with. And fun business tip for you guys, anytime you're exploring a new vendor for your business, I suggest getting 2 to 3 options. So reach out to a couple of different labs, find out who you like to work with, what their pricing is, what their timelines are, and pick the option that is the best fit for your business. Now, luckily, if this sounds a little bit like too much for you guys, we have an alternative option too. So our pre-made bases on the website have already gone through this testing. If you guys are looking to get started quickly and easily and you aren't formulating your own products, you can head to the pre-made bases on our website and we cover a wide array of skincare products from cleansers, masks, serums, and day and night creams as well, along with a plethora of other products. So if you use those, you can bypass the R&D phase that Matt and I talked about, and we still do suggest going through the production phase testing, which is very cost effective if you guys are going to be altering the product in any way. For the pre-made bases, you can use actives, fragrances, and essential oils, and as long as you don't deviate outside of our suggestions for using those pre-made bases, you can bypass the R&D testing. If you guys have any questions on this topic, drop us a comment below. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to stay in the know on all the latest makers' tips and tricks.
Thanks for watching.